With me is Tapsee Pannu. You are a big, big Bollywood star. Today we're going to talk about the badminton angle in your life. How much do you enjoy the sport?
Well, I do. That's why I'm standing here. Nobody wants to spend shitloads of money.
Tapsee, we're going to have to look there.
Okay. Nobody wants to spend so much of money out of your pocket if you don't really enjoy a sport, being the owner of the team. So yes, I love the sport. I love sports in general, and badminton in particular. I've been following for years. I've been not played it professionally, but we all love playing badminton, being Indians. So yeah, that's why I'm here, spending all that money.
By here, we do mean the Premier Badminton League auction, where Tapsee owns one of the seven franchises. And Tapsee, tell us about some of the money that you spent today, some of your hard-earned money that you spent.
Actually,
today,
you know, it's funny. Last year, when I came for the auction, we were the team who saved the most. Around like 14 lakhs we saved out of the kitty. This year, it's around 24 lakhs that we have saved in the kitty.
You have a good CA there.
So it feels like we are, I don't know about the winning team, but we are definitely the highest saving team for sure. And we have 11 players, the maximum number of players that we can have. So always try to encourage young players from across the world. And yeah, an interesting mix and match. But we have one super experienced guy, Sitavan, in our team for men's doubles. So yeah, I've been a huge fan of his game. So looking forward to having him in the team.
But do you think, you know, the Olympics are next year, so a lot of players have chosen to pull out of the Premier Badminton League. We don't have Saina, we don't have Marin. You think that's going to take away from the sheen of the league as a team owner, or do you think it's going to be the same?
See, obviously, I understand where they're coming from, and Olympics is their priority, which is fair enough, I do understand, but the game must go on. The fun of badminton is not just about having a particular set of players, but having a good competition, and I'm sure we're going to have a good competition, because from what I see on the table right now, all teams are near about similar in their, you know, they say probably in the kind of players they have put together. So it's going to be a pretty tough competition and wonderful badminton to see. I think that's what matters. That's why I'm here. It's not always about who's going to have the A star. It's about who's going to put up the best fight.
Okay, Tai Zhu Ying, women's world number one. She was one of the players who was, you know, who went under the hammer. Yes. Sindhu, of course, already was retained by her team. So, you know, I mean, obviously she was on everybody's radar. Yeah. How much was it?
Between us and the Bangalore people, and they won in the lucky draw. So, okay, the luck was probably not on our side in the auction. But I think we'll make up for it in the team eventually. Because it's not just about one match at the end of the day. It's about the entire tie. And we have five matches in the tie. So, let's see what happens.
We also did see a lot of you in the season last time round. You know, you did come out to support your team. So how do you balance your whole, you know, your work life and then, you know, your sports fan franchise owner life?
When you step into something, you do want to give it your best. Otherwise, don't step in. Mm-hmm. So when I decided to step into it, I wanted to give it my best. Otherwise, I wouldn't. Mm-hmm. So it's a part of my life, as important, if not more, than everything else. So, so yeah, I'm going to give it all I have.
Okay. You've obviously seen how all the teams have been built. Who do you think, you know, would be one of the stronger contenders this time?
Honestly, as I said right now, from whatever I could manage just after the auction, they are pretty close, all of them. It's pretty close this time. I'll have to probably go back to the table and see and assess all the teams to really know if someone has an extra edge or no. But it's going to be quite tough this time.
Growing up, you did say you did watch a lot of badminton. Any you know, any big match that you remember watching? Any Olympic final maybe? That, I mean, not really growing up, but you know, any match that you remember in particular, any player?
The biggest Olympic final that we all remember is between Karolina and Sindhu. So I think that doesn't get bigger than that. And I did watch the World Championship finals of Sindhu. And thankfully, we get a gold. We got a gold. So yeah, so I mean, these are the matches we remember. But I've seen a lot of live matches as well, which I really detest now because my heartbeat really goes erratic when I see Indian players play, because it's like, you know, you almost like you want to win at any cost there, and nothing is in your hand, not even the racket.
Yeah, just clap.
So that's very nerve-wracking.
I know it's probably not a question you want to be asked as a team owner, but Team Sindhu, Saina, if you were to pick one of them, who would you go for? I mean, if you had like a free reign.
Whoever's coming in my team, whoever's ready to come to my team, ask both the girls. I can choose whoever is ready to come to my team, ditch their teams or decide to come in PBL and come to my team.
Okay, that's an open plea from Tapsee Pannu, owner of Pune 7 Aces. Good luck for your season next year.
Thank you.
Thank you.